It's been about a month since I blogged, and I always say when I do a blog, I haven't blogged for a long time because I'm really busy. And I'm starting to think, well, one, everybody's busy, but two, I'm just a little more distracted and unorganized. I got to tell you my squirrel story. It's about being distracted and unorganized. A number of years ago, there was a movie called Up. It was a cartoon movie with Walter Matthau. It was about this old man whose wife had died, and in the movie, there was a talking dog. And the dog had a role in the movie like everybody else did, but being a dog, every time he saw a squirrel, he'd go, "Squirrel!" So he'd be talking away, doing something, and squirrel, he'd be over there. Well, that kind of describes what I've been like this last little while. Oh, well, my whole life. We had the Tuesday night class, and they're a fun group of ladies. It all ties in, give me time. And the neat thing about them is self-directed drop-in. So there's not a class. They come when they can and work on what they want, and I help them if I can. So there's any evening, any Tuesday night, we have anywhere from 6 to 12 ladies all working on 6 to 12 different things. And they laugh at me and call me squirrel because I told them about the movie too. And lady number one will be working on something and I'll say, oh, she needs this widget, and I'll go grab it for her. But over there I see lady number five is on the way to crash and burn, so I go to help her. And then I see number two and squirrel and squirrel, and the whole evening goes on, me being this sort of butterfly teacher going around this table helping the ladies, being as distracted and as much as I can. And so the other morning we're having our coffee, and Jim looks out the window, and now out our living room window at home we have these two big trees, and he says, there's a squirrel out there. And I go sneaking out there because I don't want to scare away the squirrel. I don't want to show in the window. And one of my Kelly Westerhart evening ladies bought a metal squirrel sculpture and stuck it in spikes in my front yard, and it took Jim and I a week or more to even see that it was there. Anyway, I have been distracted and confused. But I'm back, and we're gearing up for the summer. What's happening here in Canada this summer, it's their 150th birthday party, and all the national parks are free. And that affects me because I hope to sell a whole bunch of mugs. And so I've been gearing up by making a boatload of mugs. And brings the question, if I made a boatload of mugs and we're in Alberta, how do I deliver them? But that's not your problem. So I'm working on mugs. I'm hoping for a very muggy summer. Also brings me to the next thing is consignment versus wholesale. I've talked about this before in a blog, and I really do prefer consignment. Now these pots here are consignment. They're for a little store. It's only their second or third year in business. There's no way they could afford to buy this many pots. They've got these bowls. We've got yarn bowls and batter bowls and just bowls and clay test bowls that we'll talk about later. But all these bowls will go to the park. I'll probably have 2 dozen of these little platters with mountain scenes on them, and they'll go as inventory, and we'll talk about these mugs in a bit. But I can give that store as much pottery as I like. I really do prefer consignment because you can put in the amount you want to put in. You can put in the glazes and the color and display how you want to be displayed. You control the price, and like I said, you put in even though they can't afford to have you in there. Now I also have another store in another park, and he's always ordered wholesale. And he will phone me up, and always the last minute, but anyway, he will either email me or phone me and say I need, and he will order, he'll tell me what to make, how many to make, what color to make, and hopefully when to make them. Now the perk is when wholesale, you do get paid right away. As soon as you make your pots, you ship them off, and he pays 50% of the retail I have determined. But just because I say that's the retail price, I don't have control over it after he owns them. I sell my mugs for $25. I put them in consignment, I get 15. I sell them to the wholesaler for $12.50. He can sell them for 30 or 35 or whatever he likes. I don't have control over them after they leave me. And also, even if he does sell them for 25, I'm only getting 50%, whereas consignment I get 60. So for every $100 sold consignment, I get 60, and for every $100 sold wholesale, I get $50. Anyway, and I don't like being told what to do. However, the market does dictate somewhat and tell me what to do, which again brings me to mugs. And the last thing I'm going to talk about, and then I'm going to get busy, is weighing mugs. And I've been doing these videos for a while, and people say, how much does that weigh? And I haven't really started weighing that much. But I do now. I did a mug video a while ago, and it was a series on how to make mugs and handles. And one person said, boy, that is a sloppy throw. And it was, because mugs for me are mugs. Like, I made lots. They're not a representation of my art. They're a mug, and if it's not perfect, I always say pots are like people, very few of us are perfect. But anyway, weighing mugs, I've got these weighed out. I'll get these made today. A regular mug for me weighs about 500 grams, which is about a pound. And I'll cut that off, and that will be weighed better once the scale is on. There we go. And I like these, just digital scales are just easier. So that's 529. It's good enough. It was 504, it was 550. I would keep it, so that's five. And so I'm gonna do one that's just a little bit too small. This one's 444 grams, so I need 50 grams. I just want to show you how little 50 grams is. That was 63 grams. So now we're at 513. So you can see in weighing your clay out, it's a ballpark amount. Now this is going to be too big, so I'll cut off again. That's going to be a little under. That's 506. So this bit of clay can change the amount. There's 533. So weighing your clay, if that much is in the mug ball for throwing or not, is not going to make a whole lot of difference. But anyway, so I just want to talk about weighing clay. And it doesn't make that much difference as long as you're kind of in the same size. So I'm going to throw these mugs today. It's somehow the day has sneaked up to noon and I haven't done much. I'm not going to trim these. These I threw yesterday and they're too wet to trim. But I want to trim them tomorrow. And if I don't put some air on them today, I won't be trimming them tomorrow either. It's windy and cold and yucky. So I'll throw a bunch of mugs. I got a lady coming at 1:30. I'll throw mugs, I'll go home, probably won't take the dogs out. We talk about our dogs because it's rainy, cold, and yucky. We'll go home, it's Friday afternoon, it'll be a day.